tone deafness, trend following, getting clowned on online after making a very, very out of touch statement. These are a few things that come to mind when you think Sony, especially given current events. Sony's chief financial officer, Hiroki Titoki, that's not how you pronounce it, but that's how I'm gonna pronounce it, just said, "We don't have any IPs." Yeah, what do you call all of these, man? So apparently, during the interview, they said that the company needs to put more of a focus in creating its own intellectual properties moving forward. But what the fuck? Just use the ones you've already got.
It's my IP to sit on and do nothing with.
It's not like Nintendo was like, alright, Mario Sunshine didn't do too good. We're just dropping Mario. No more Mario stuff. We're gonna focus on Butt World. Literally getting clowned on online, everybody's just like, use the ones you already have. Little Big Planet, Sly Cooper, Bloodborne. That one's not really a Sony IP, it's a From Software IP, but still, it's on a Sony console, so it counts, right? I don't know. Patapon, I'm talking about Ape Escape. Freaking fix the port on PS5. I tried to play it the other day, it's awful. Taking care of the stuff you've already got now will definitely go a long way. You don't need new IPs, clearly. You can't handle them. What they're saying is that they want IPs like Spider-Man that are like multi-million dollar franchises. But they're not gonna have Mario. Mario didn't start out huge, dude. They built upon what they already had. Sony's just like, let's do the one and done. That doesn't fucking work. That's not how you build a brand. That's building something and then being like, all right, throw that shit away. Let's try Concourse next. So where's this all coming from? Well, you may or may not have heard that Concord, Sony's latest game that they sunk $200 million into, just flopped harder than that one guy in the ASDF movie.
Everybody do the flop.
It's just Sony doing the flop today. After an 8-year development cycle, this project didn't last as long as the average common housefly. It's like, I get what they were going for. They're like, dude, Overwatch. Everybody's into Overwatch. Let's make a new Overwatch. Back when Overwatch was actually popular. And it's been 8 years since then. Everybody's just like, what the fuck? Overwatch? It's out. Overwatch 2 is out, technically. Nobody cares anymore. Read the room. Put that one on the back burner. Why did it fail? Well, that's the question, isn't it? I think this is a good way of saying current market research style games do not work. Focus groups of that kind do not work when it comes to games. They listen to the loud minority who don't have any interest in buying their products. Those people just want to complain loudly how things should be, but that doesn't lead to fun or interesting games. It's an attempt to make a safe space that's all-encompassing and diverse, but the thing is, that's not how art works. Art pushes boundaries. It makes you question reality and the human condition. It's not going to be a one-size-fits-all thing, and that's okay. You can't always be who you want to be, feel how you want to feel, or even do what you want to do. Sometimes art is risky, but it pays off. Sometimes your artistic vision is too fat. Fucking slams a ham right in your face. And some people are gonna say, ew, what? Who wants a big fucking butt? Ew, gross. Fucking everybody wants that shit. Look at how this game sold. And it's for these two big reasons. Interesting art design and... Sorry, what were we talking about? Isn't it ironic that Concord is dying in the same day that they're releasing Astrobot, a game that celebrates past IPs? Astrobot really shows how many IPs Sony has. You're the head of whatever. Just look at your own product, you dandy fuck. You dare to come in here and say Sony ain't got no IPs? You want that next Spider-Man? You want that next Mario? You want that next big money spinner? This is what you need to do more of. You need to earn it by listening to fans. Not focus groups, not market researchers, fans of the games that you've been neglecting. What we have is a bunch of lesser-known, for now, IPs that you can make bigger. You can make Ape Escape into the next Zelda. You can make Sly Cooper into the next Mario. Not literally, those are different genres. You know what I'm trying to say. And if you don't, I'm sorry. I don't know how to help you. Medical science just isn't there yet. Astrobot is a huge step forward for this whole situation. Astro's Playroom is like a tech demo for the PS5. And it comes with the console for free. I played through it 3 times. It was so good. It took them 8 years and 200 mil to come up with Concord, a game that was dead on arrival. Look at this character design. There's just nothing. It's just homogenized schlock. There's no thought, no love put into this. It's terrible. People will often complain about character design. This girl has big titties and that makes me uncomfortable. Fuck you! Who doesn't love big titties? You're not even gonna buy the game. You just want to complain, and I'm complaining about the complainers complaining. So it's just a vicious circle. Just put those titties out there. Everybody's gonna love it. Look at Stellar Blade. That's a game that came out. Everybody fucking loved her ass. I don't know about the game. I literally just know that everybody liked her design. And that is a jumping off point. That's what people are going to remember, is the art design. It's the same thing with 2B. You can show her to goddamn anybody, and they'll be like, yeah, it's 2B right there. No, I didn't play her game, but I saw her on Rule 34 while I was fapping away. How many times can I talk about 2B's butt in one video? Anyways, art direction. Astrobot. Look at this. It's cute as heck, yo. I love that they made a bigger version of Astro's Playroom. And this game came out yesterday as of time of writing, and it's already getting Game of the Year review scores. This is what they hoped Concord was going to get. So what is all this leading into? Well, what can we do about this situation? How do we let these corporate cronies and the people making games not for the fans, but for the stockholders, how do we tell them, hey, make games for us, not these money grubbers? Because what they want is something that will sell instantly. But what they don't realize is that if they make something the fans love, the money will surely follow. Well, you vote with your wallet. Nobody bought Concord, and that's why they shut it down. Why did no one buy it? Well, all the other Hero Arena shooters are free to play. So when you slap a $40 price tag on there, you're going against all your competition, which is basically free, brings to mind the phrase, you're only as smart as your dumbest competitor. If you're offering lemonade for $3, and then Jimmy down the street's offering lemonade for 25 cents, they're gonna go for the cheaper option every time. And now if Astrobot does well, maybe they'll take a look at it and be like, oh, shoot. So people do like the stuff that we've already got going on, and maybe we should do more of that. And then we can all look at them with squinted eyes and be like, yeah, more of that. Also, if you're one of the 25 people that has a PS5, play Astrobot. You don't even have to play the new one, although it's good. Play Astro's Playroom. It's free. It literally came with your console. And when you're done, head to Rule 34 and look at Nier Automata. Okay, bye.